Hello students, I am Jay Patel from Vasis Vidyalaya and I am going to teach you 10th standard physics. Students, let's continue with our chapter number 13, magnetic effects of electric current. Now students, in this video I would like to teach you activity number 13.6 and I will discuss right hand thumb rule, because right hand thumb rule should be utilized in this activity 13.6, and afterwards I will discuss certain questions and answer based on this activity, and finally I am giving you certain homework so that you have to write in your physics notebook. Now this is students or activity number 13.6. It is available on our NCERT textbook page number 229. So student, I already taught you that how you write the activity in exam. So you have to follow this particular step. So step one is aim, second is materials required, third is you have to draw the diagram, fourth one is procedure, fifth one is observation, and sixth one is conclusion or maybe discussion and result. So that way you have to write. So let's start this activity number 13.6. so that is what is the aim of this activity. So it is says that to study the pattern of magnetic field due to the current carrying circular coil. So this is the aim of the activity, or maybe it should be asked like that way, that which type of the pattern can be formed by with the help of circular coil. In my last video, in activity number 13.5, we have discussed which type of pattern can be generated with the help of straight copper wire. So here in this activity, we have to study which type of pattern can be generated with the help of circular coil. So for performing this activity, which materials are required? So students, materials are battery of 12 volt, rheostat, an emitter, plug key, rectangular cardboard, compass, iron fillings, a salt sprinkler, and circular coils having a large number of turns. So these materials are required to perform this activity. Then what is the procedure of this activity? So the first point is that take the rectangular cardboard having two holes, insert a circular coil having a large number of turns through them and normal to the plane of cardboard, and cardboard does not move. So this way we have to arrange the this coil and cardboard. This is our first point. Second, connect the ends of the coil in series with the battery, key, rheostat as shown as given in the figure below. It means that then all the apparatus we have to connect here. Student, this is the textbook diagram. In that one, rheostat is not connected, but if we want to utilize, so we have to connect the rheostat and emitter also. So this way we have to connect all the apparatus like this way. Then next number point is that sprinkle some iron fillings uniformly on the cardboard. So students, you can see that we can pass the circular coil from the two holes of the cardboard, and then afterwards we have to arrange this all the apparatus, and then after we have to sprinkle some iron fillings on the cardboard. So iron fillings now remain here and there. It should not be forming any pattern. So for sprinkling iron filling, we can utilize a sprinkler also, or we can say the salt sprinkler also. Now after arranging all that things, we have to finally plug the key. Plug the key means we have to switch on the circuit. And then after last step of this activity, that tape the cardboard gently a few times. So we have to tape the cardboard slowly for 5 to 6 times, and note the pattern of the iron fillings that emerge on the cardboard. So here which type of pattern it has been formed, so we have to see. So after inserting this key, we have to tap this cardboard for 5 to 6 times, and then afterwards we can see that here this type of pattern can be generated. So students, so you can see it pattern, it is given in our textbook diagram. So this way it should be generated. So it means that it is forming circular pattern on the left hand side and right hand side, and in the straight it should be pass a straight magnetic field lines. So these type of magnetic field lines, concentric circles and straight magnetic field lines can be generated in the case of circular coil. So this way we can perform this activity, and we have to write the observation. The magnetic field lines near the coil are circular and concentric. The direction of the magnetic field at the center is perpendicular to the plane of the coil, and magnetic field is maximum at the center. So this is our observation. And students, now we have to find that, you can see that here circles are formed in this particular activity. So circles are rotated two ways, one is clockwise and second is anti-clockwise. So circle are rotated, or we can say that magnetic field lines are rotated this way. So in which circle we have to keep which type of arrow, in either we have to keep clockwise or anti-clockwise. So for finding these things, so we have to use here right hand thumb rule. So first understand what is right hand thumb rule, so that I have already taught you in activity number 13.5, but this is a sort of revision. So the right hand thumb rule is like that way. You have to write this statement. Imagine that you are holding a current carrying straight conductor in your right hand, such that the thumb points towards the direction of the current, and then your finger will wrap around the conductor in the direction of the field lines of the magnetic field as shown as given in this figure, and this is known as the right hand thumb rule. So this is considered to be right hand thumb rule. It means that in right hand thumb rule, thumb will represent the direction of the current, and the wrap of your finger or curl of your finger will showing the direction of the magnetic field. So here students, if you see that if the thumb is in downward direction, if current is going in downward direction, then see the direction of the finger. So it should be moving in the clockwise. So here the direction of magnetic field is clockwise, and if we take the thumb over in upward direction, so at that time the magnetic field moving anti-clockwise. So this way we can find the direction of the magnetic field by using the right hand thumb rule. Now students, you can draw this diagram also in exam. So in textbook that it is not given clearly, so you can draw this diagram also, so that is clear also, and this is easy also. So this way you connect the all apparatus. Now you know that current is passing here from positive terminal of the battery to negative terminal of the battery. So students, you can see that in the left hand side cardboard, when current goes in the upward side in circular coil, so we have to apply the here right hand thumb rule. So right hand thumb rule we have to apply. So at that time thumb will represent the direction of the current, and curl of our finger will represent the direction of magnetic field line. So here if current is moving in upper direction, then left hand side these circles are formed. So all the circles direction or magnetic field lines direction should be anti-clockwise. And students, you can see that one arrow is given above the cardboard. So it means that now in the right hand side current is coming downward direction. So if current is coming in downward direction, so we have to apply the right hand thumb rule. So at that time, if the current is coming downward direction, then curl of your finger, you can see the direction of the curl of the finger, so it is moving the clockwise. So in right hand side all the circles direction should be clockwise, or magnetic field lines are moving clockwise direction. So this way, by applying the right hand thumb rule, we can find the direction of the magnetic line. And in circular loop, here left hand side and right hand side all the circles are forming, but their direction should be one should be clockwise and one should be anti-clockwise. So this way we can understand. So you can understand this better way. All the circle direction, left hand side, it is moving, current is moving, you can see it here, upward direction. So left hand side upward direction, so magnetic field anti-clockwise, and you can see that here current is moving in the means right hand side cardboard, it moving downward direction. So here all the circles are clockwise direction in the right hand side cardboard, and in a straight, in the center of circular loop, magnetic field line is passed straight. So this way we can understand this activity. I hope you understand this activity, and students, let's discuss certain questions and answers based on this activity. So first question is that what happens to the strength of magnetic field if we move towards the center of the coil? So answer is that if we move towards the center of the coil, the strength of magnetic field is increasing. So it magnetic field strength should be increasing. Second, where is the magnetic field maximum? So the magnetic field is maximum at the center. Then third question, write the factors on which the strength of the magnetic field depends. So students, it should be depend on three factors. The first one is magnitude of the current, second one is radius of the coil R, and third one is the number of turns in the coil. So that is denoted with the N. And students, you know that magnetic field is denoted with the B. So we can say that magnetic field is directly proportional to the current. Second, magnetic field is inversely proportional to the radius of the coil. And third one is magnetic field is directly proportional to the number of turns in the coil. So this way we can discuss all questions and answer based on this activity. Now students, I am giving you certain questions that you have to write in your physics notebook. So the first question is that you have to describe this activity in physics notebook. So you have to draw the diagram also. You follow the all steps: aim, apparatus, procedure, diagram, observation, conclusion and result. This way you have to write in physics notebook. And second question, you write the right hand thumb rule. So I hope you understand this activity. Thank you very much.